everyone
I know,
for years.
Me in front of a camera, mic'd up, living the dream. Why am I ever going to get nervous? That's me living my best life.
Clout chaser, isn't it?
Stop saying that. You're making it a thing. It's not a thing.
I think Megan was asked, do you know any good, any...
Good-looking boys?
No, you weren't going to say that.
Hello, I'm Jordan.
And I'm Saffron.
Hi, I'm Junaid from The Only Way is Essex.
And I'm Roman.
And we're going to be spilling the tea on our TOWIE secrets.
Here with Closer.
Oh dear. It was a long time ago. I got approached about going on to TOWIE when I was in a relationship, so I thought, oh no, I'll swerve that. Too messy. And then I done Diva España with Gemma, and then they poached me from that.
I didn't actually get approached. Danny got approached for one of the casting crew, and they asked her if she had any friends, and obviously me and my best friend come on with Danny to like get interviewed about TOWIE, and me and Danny ended up getting picked.
Mine was when I was quite a bit younger. I'm extremely close family friends with Megan McKenna and obviously knew all the girls through her, Chloe, Courtney. We used to hang around with them quite a bit. And I think Megan was asked, do you know any good, any?
Good looking boys.
No, you weren't gonna say that.
I mean, my first ever meeting with TOWIE was when I was actually 18, so absolute years ago. Because at the time, when I was 18, two of my best friends were on the show. Obviously didn't happen. And then a few years later, TOWIE got back in contact. Still didn't happen. And then I got a call this year from the execs, and they were like, we want you to come on the show. And it was literally so quick, and then I was going to Dominican.
So back then you was relevant, really?
I wasn't irrelevant. Timing is everything, Roman, in life, okay? You're 20, darling.
So Megan was asked, do you know any single boys that would be good for the show? And she said my name. This time round, they approached me again and said, how do you feel about coming back? So I'm back for round two.
Oh no, I'm not good with auditions.
No.
They just see me as I was. I mean, me and Gemma, we had quite a close bond, so I would put her in her place if she was wrong. And I think that's what they liked, that I was outspoken. And that was it. 2 weeks later, I was in. I don't know what I was doing. I was doing something weird. I do know what I was doing. I was cleansing Gemma's shop with sage. That's how I started, and I'm still doing that now, and it ain't give me much joy, to be honest, the sage.
Ain't working.
Nah.
Give it up.
I've gone to the crystals, what I ain't done.
So when I signed the contract to go on TOWIE, none of my friends knew I was going on the show. So Danny, Ella, Yaz, no one knew I was going on the show. Had to keep it a secret, but obviously.
You didn't know as well.
When I arrived at the airport, I was so tired. I had my hood up, everything, my suitcase. Looked up and I see him. I'm thinking, what the f*** are you doing there? Like, why are you here? And he actually came. I was baffled.
Yeah, literally kept it a secret, and everyone saw me at the airport.
But yeah, no, I think you have to keep it a secret, obviously, until you're actually aired on the show, I think.
We went up to the offices for interviews in the offices.
You have like story chats.
Yeah, I remember that. And then it was me and Jack. I think to settle the nerves, we had half a pint before we went in, and that made it a bit easier. So we went in. And had a right bubbly chat with all the producers and everything like that. And then, yeah, similar to Saf, 2 weeks after that, we was in.
I was filming the next week, so it was very quick for me.
Me and Jack, when we first came on the show, we had to keep it like top secret for quite a while. We found out really early doors.
Oh, really?
Because they started filming the series in Tenerife, I think, and we weren't invited. So we was coming on like halfway through the series. So we had to keep it really quiet while they went to Tenerife and everything like that. My dad, being my dad, is the worst person at keeping anything quiet. And he was singing in our local pub with all my family, everyone. There's about 80 people in the pub. And me and Jack had been filming TOWIE, so we couldn't go to the pub. But my dad knew where he was, but none of the pub knew where he was. So me and Jack was like 3 hours late. So me and Jack got out of a cab, walked into the pub, and my dad put The Only Way Is Up on the speakers, full blast.
No,
so the whole pub was like, we all know where you've been. Secret was out, you know?
When I joined the show, I actually knew every cast member. The only two cast members that I hadn't met and spoken to were Saffron and Harry.
I only knew Lockie, to be fair. Lockie and Yaz.
Who do you think had a better reaction joining the show, you or Junaid?
Oh, me all day. People was happy to see me. Should have met him.
Nah.
You didn't?
Nah. I had a scene with Gemma and Bobby, and they were sort of bickering as usual, and I was just sitting back there with me Rocky Road.
And sage.
And a robe.
Oh yeah, of course. I was bricks. Like, obviously it's the first time like on camera properly. Don't know what to think. Whereas now I've done 3 series, I think I just find it natural. Like, it's so easy to do it now. We've done it for so long.
I think for me, this time round was very different. Like I've said in previous interviews, I'm sort of a lot more confident this time round, coming back that bit older. Obviously, I do quite a bit on stage with my dad, whether it's singing or sort of talking. So that's brought my confidence back. So that made me feel a lot better being in front of a camera. But I remember, do remember the first time around when me and Jack filmed our first scenes. Obviously, I was only 21. Bear in mind, me and Jack are two people who could talk. What's the saying? Talk the hind legs off a donkey. Is that right, Sam? Isn't it? We could talk the hind legs off a donkey.
They're slow though.
And they sat, we've got all the cameras on, everything like that. We didn't stop yakking the whole time. They went, right, action. And we've got to talk to each other like that.
My first scene was obviously with Roman, Danny and Yaz. And I wasn't nervous at all, really. I was so excited that I was ready to go.
With Towie, it's a reality show. And if you're willing to put your real life out there, then why are you going to be nervous? Like, you're going into it. You know what you're putting yourself through. Yeah, it's weird at first, cameras mic'd up and things. That's not the usual, but no, I had a clonic this series, you'll see.
This is what you want. This is what you want for years.
No, I know, putting me in front of a camera, mic'd up, living the dream. Why am I ever going to get nervous? That's me living my best life.
Clout chaser, isn't it?
Stop saying that. You're making it a thing. It's not a thing. I'm just out here trying to live my best life and follow my dreams.
Yeah.
No, but I did love Thailand. We went to Thailand. That was an amazing experience. I got to feed the elephants in the sanctuary. We're lucky. Like every day filming is always different. It's always something different. So we're having an amazing time.
Yeah.
I'd say every scene that I film, I absolutely love and enjoy. Love doing
it. Mm-hmm. I'd say the same thing because obviously you're filming, isn't it? So
like the everyday scenes are really fun, but then some of the argumentative scenes and like the catty scenes. They are really interesting and your emotions do get riled up. So I feel like my argumentative scenes have been my most kind of emotional ones, yeah.
I think so. I think scenes-wise, I think me and you have had some good scenes.
Yeah.
Your moving out scene with your dad was brilliant. Obviously, I've known Saf's family for a lot of years, including her dad. I've got a few different ones. I've got, like in the series, I don't want to say too much because you haven't seen it all yet, but I have a bit of a different time. I go from being sort of a very happy, jolly, always the one making sure everyone's okay. I go through quite a serious time and my favourite scene is further down the line when we get some good news and everybody's there.
I think this series has been really relatable for the viewers.
Yeah.
It's not just been glitz, glam, teeth, tits. It's been the highs and lows of life, what everyone goes through. Mm. And I think that's why this series has done so well and will do well.
I think this series has definitely shown a lot more family aspects of people. So like me with you, me with Amy, You with your dad, me with my mum. I think you can really see how we are.
It's opened up.
Yeah, definitely. How we do live our day-to-day lives, you know? And we do go through some struggles and some...
normal things.
Brilliant times as well.
Would you prefer the emotional ones or the funny sort of ones? Not emotional, the arguments. Because I know you love arguing.
I do prefer the argument scenes.
I don't. See, I prefer the funny scenes. Especially when I see Pete Wicks. That's the funniest guy to film with. I'm sorry, it is.
I've never filmed a scene with him.
Yeah, because you're just... this.
Because we're not friends.
Yeah. What I've done is I was talking about my love life. It's already aired. And I said that I had my house rendered and then the geezer rendered me. Well, basically, I went to a boxing match the other night and three blokes asked me if...
they weren't renderers, were they?
No. They said, can we render you? And I thought it was disgusting, looked like I was like really a prude. And I thought, you know what, you can't say anything. You've said it on national TV now. Do I regret it? No, I just wish I could have something else rendered.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
You only have three scenes, we all right.
No, there's scenes coming up. We did a talent show, so the talent show scene, I'm gonna cringe so bad. That's going to be a cringe scene, yeah.
No, I don't think we'll know cringe scenes, to be fair.
The talent show's a bit much for me as well. Basically, I've got a really, really, really good talent.
It's brilliant.
Did I win it?
Let's say she swooped everyone off her feet.
And
Did I
win it? No. Oh, I didn't even get through, I don't think. Anyway, I was too good. I was too good, so they didn't put me through. Basically, I can do.
No.
It's all to do with my movement.
Flexibility. Yeah. Feet. Yeah, there might be a couple of scenes coming up that make me cringe. Involving, I think where you might have potentially got a bit involved with someone you didn't want to get involved with, and now you got to watch it and think, oh God.
I think some of the cast of Towie are very clever in how they like to perform in front of camera. And I think with myself, I know a lot of the cast on screen and off screen. And I think a lot of them do play up to portraying themselves a certain type of way when the cameras are rolling. Whereas with myself, what you see is what you get.
obviously from watching the show, I feel like everyone, obviously because I film with them, I watch the show and I think, yeah, I just think they're the exact same. I don't know what Janae's going on about, honestly, but you know what I mean?
Do you know what? I don't know everyone off the show, how they are with like their real friends and family, because we're on a show together, but obviously we've got our own friendship groups and there's people that get on and don't. To create a show like this and show your lives, I think everyone does an amazing job. We don't all like each other, but we're all there to do a job and we're all opening ourselves... What the f***? We're all opening ourselves up and I think, like, everyone needs to be proud of that, really.
I just think cast members like Chloe Brockett, when they first come on the show, and obviously I've known them for years, how they're kind of portraying themselves this series is very different to how they are in real life, so.
I think, especially this year, I think everyone does sort of portray themselves how they are, from what I know. You know, especially in my closest circle, obviously me and the boys, and then you've got me and you. I think you are as you come, do you know what I mean? Amy,
Harry. How do you feel about that? Me
coming
as I can.
Dominican, we had some good times in Dominican,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, we did. Listen, trolling should never happen, but we have opened our lives up, so we are going to get opinions. And if no one's talking about you, you're doing a shit job. Mm. If you're being spoke about, you're doing something right, whether it's good or bad. And if someone calls you a name, like, they're only tapping away probably with their 100th fag and their 10th coffee. Doing nothing with their lives, so.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I love it.
Caught some clout.
No, honestly.
You got to remember that there's 7 billion people in the world. You're never going to please everyone. I'll find that, if I'm honest with you, I'll find that fairly hard at the start, because I think I always want to keep everyone happy.
Yeah, no, you're a people pleaser. Just drop your guard. You ain't really that sweet.
Oh, do me a favour. That's a low blow.
Everywhere I go, people stop me, and I absolutely love it. Went to Lakeside the other day, quite a few people stopped me. Went to get bread from my corner shop the other day, someone stopped me. Can't say I don't like it. Don't even lie and say you don't like it.
What? But when it happens, Manchester's different.
Last week, people were screaming, oh my God, you're from town. And I was like, hi, nice to meet you. You love it.
Do you know the one that I don't like, though? Listen, there's one thing that's done my head in from really early, but even like now more so. When people go, here she goes again, stirring, we're here to make a TV show. Do you think that I just sit there talking about everyone's lives every day, all day, but we've got to pass the information on? Like, I got so badly annihilated for passing the voice note that spelt that tea that didn't really cause much of a reaction to Amber, but I got like caned for sharing that voice note, but we're there to make a show. What are we gonna do? Like, oh, I'll just sit on that in Dominican and then we've got no storyline.
Yeah.
We're there to do our job.
Of course.
And that's what I do, and I'm good at it.
I've never sent a voice note since.
See, I don't mind it, obviously. If it happens, it happens. I'm always gonna say, yeah, you can get a picture or whatever, but
I think if anyone in Towie says they don't enjoy the attention from the public is lying.
Yeah, it's definitely lying if you don't say don't enjoy the attention, because I think everyone does.
Should we try and guess each other's?
Really?
I know what you're going to say mine is. Where I go all the time.
Yeah, I know what you're going to say.
Yeah.
Jordan, you'll find him down the Fatlin or the New Inn most weeks.
They're my two local pubs.
The
Fatlin sponsors my football team and we're in there every week and I love everyone in there. It's right
not,
on my doorstep.
It's not a promo, Mark. You're not doing a promo.
No,
but
that's my favourite place.
I'm going to say the one that everyone else just says all the time, sheesh. Sheesh is the main one that everyone goes to.
Love sheesh.
I like to go for pie and mash, to be honest, with a bit of liquor.
Yeah.
Robins, yeah.
I was going to say some sort of like retreat with crystals and spiritual stuff.
I like a Thai massage, yeah.
Flower Thai, Om Church.
Yeah.
Could never get a slot there because Saf books them all.
I booked 2.5 hours.
Yeah, yeah. Can you just tell me another hour?
I like going to see the deer and feeding them carrots, and I like walking around the duck pond. I like the simple things in life.
Do you know what? I have to say, the Thai cast member that I would bring back is Gemma Collins. She is absolutely iconic, so. She's someone that I'd love to film with when she comes back, if she comes back.
Oh my God, I'd bring Gemma back so I could have the standoff that I've been waiting for.
Wow. Ballsy, that.
Joey Essex. Joey Essex, that's my twin, even though he's white and I'm black. Can I say that?
Probably bring back Arj. I think I've cut Arj's hair for years and years and years.
I might bring him back so I can have a little rendezvous with him, actually.
Oh, wow.
I don't do groups, honey. I'm on my own on that show.
Yeah, not in a group chat.
No.
I'm in one group chat. I'm in a group chat with the boys. We planned a big Ibiza trip. Unfortunately, it didn't happen.
Oh, what? Yeah.
We had it as like Ibiza boys and Gatsby because we had the four cool ones. I'm joking.
Me, Dad. So there's. I mean, there's loads. We've got loads of type of group chats. So when we started filming the show, me, Danny, Yaz, and Ella had a group chat called The Bitches, which is still there.
We were at Manchester the other day, so we made one.
Yeah, we've got a group chat, me, Danny, and Roman, which I'm always in the middle of.
Why didn't Ibiza happen?
I just didn't get around to it. Yeah. People got busy, other things happened. It'll happen in the future. Why, you want to come? Do you want to get in a group chat?
Yeah.
Nice.
I ain't got no group chats, to be fair, apart from
them.
Yeah, not you.
I'm Jordan.
And I'm Saffron.
Hi, I'm Junaid from The Only Way is Essex.
And I'm Roman.
And these were our TOWIE secrets.
Shh.